Thanks for tuning in. This is The Life of a Miner, and let's check out week 62 of my mining payouts. Okay, so at the beginning of these payout videos, let's do a quick spot check of the date and time. Today is May 21st of 2020, and it's about 12 p.m. U.S. Eastern Time. So like previous weeks, I've been mining Ethereum, and I do want to mention that I did decrease the power on my mining rigs because it is getting hot, so I do average around 990 mega hashes mining Ethereum. I've been also mining Grincoin, and I do average around 75 grass per second. I've been mining Ravencoin, and I do average around 87 mega hashes. And last but not least, I've been mining Monero on my CPU, and I do average around 14 kilo hashes. Okay, so now pulling up my Excel and checking out what I mined. I did mine around 0.49 Ethereum, equaling around $98.39, about 177.2 Grincoin, equaling around $78.30, about 1,286.05 Ravencoin, equaling around $23.30, and about 0.05 Monero, equaling around $3.07. So if I did sell everything as of today, I would have made $203.06. Okay, so now checking out my GPU count, I do have a total of 80 GPUs and 1 CPU. My GPUs are mining Ethereum, Grincoin, and Ravencoin. I do have one mining rig that's speculative mining, and my CPU is mining Monero. And I do have two mining farms. Okay, so for this week's fun clip, this is actually two clips from 60 Minutes interviewing the Federal Reserve Chairman in 2009 and most recently in 2020. And this may be the rocket for Bitcoin. Now, this clip is sort of a downer, so I added a bonus fun clip at the end. And I will have all the links below in the description, so let's check this out.
In the midst of the crisis, Bernanke had freedom to act immediately. He doesn't need prior permission from Congress or the president. While they debated on Capitol Hill, Bernanke cut interest rates nearly to zero. Then he used Depression-era emergency powers to launch a dozen rescue programs of his own. There was support for money market funds, mortgages, short-term lending to small businesses, and support for auto loans, student loans, and small business loans. Commitments of $1 trillion, doubling the size of the Fed's balance sheet.
Is that tax money that the Fed is spending?
It's not tax money. The banks have accounts with the Fed, much the same way that you have an account in a commercial bank. So to lend to a bank, we simply use the computer to mark up the size of the account that they have with the Fed. So it's much more akin, although not exactly the same, but it's much more akin to printing money than it is to borrowing.
You've been printing money.
Well, effectively, and we need to do that because our economy is very weak and inflation is very low. When the economy begins to recover, that'll be the time that we need to unwind those programs, raise interest rates, reduce the money supply, and make sure that we have a recovery that does not involve inflation.
He's not kidding about printing money. The Fed issues U.S. currency. That's why it says Federal Reserve Note on all the bills in your wallet. The Fed is the source of all U.S. currency, and it regulates the economy by setting interest rates. In the Depression, it was given vast power to lend money in an emergency. It used that authority for the first time in the 2008 collapse, and for the second time, 9 weeks ago.
Has the Fed done all it can do?
Well, there's a lot more we can do. We're not out of ammunition by a long shot. No, there's really no limit to what we can do with these lending programs that we have.
In March, as the Dow collapsed 8,000 points and credit markets began to freeze, Powell called an emergency meeting on a Sunday. He cut interest rates to near zero, and in partnership with the Treasury, the Federal Reserve offered more than $3 trillion in lending to banks, businesses, cities, and states. With that assurance, the credit markets, essential to daily business, began to function again.
Fair to say you simply flooded the system with money?
Yes, we did. That's another way to think about it. We did.
Where does it come from? Do you just print it?
We print it digitally. So we as a central bank, we have the ability to create money digitally, and we do that by buying treasury bills or bonds or other government guaranteed securities, and that actually increases the money supply. We also print actual currency, and we distribute that through the Federal Reserve banks.
But by law, Chairman Powell's Federal Reserve can only lend money that must be paid back. Congress, he believes, should spend money to expand its historic bailout. After all, he says this emergency is nothing like 2008. Among the options, extending the increase in unemployment benefits, which expires in July, and supporting local governments which are struggling with a collapse in tax revenue. Powell believes trillions in additional federal debt could be paid down over decades.
The U.S. has been spending more than it's been taking in for some time, and that's something we're going to have to deal with. The time to do that is when the economy is strong, when unemployment is low, when economic activity is high. That's when you deal with that problem. This is not the time to prioritize that concern. We have the ability to borrow at low rates. We have the ability to service that debt. And I would say this is the time when we can, I would say, the U.S. economy will recover. We'll get back to the place we were in February. We'll get to an even better place than that. I'm highly confident of that. So I think we're going to need to help each other through this. And we will.
Bitcoin, please go to moon. Stop going sideways now. Don't ever say we going down to 1K, but Mr. Novokrat say we have bottomed out. Bottomed out, Novokrat is bullish. Bottomed out, don't ever rise his bearish.
Bearish positive, 1300.
Novokrat is bullish.
Bitcoin can be at 40,000.
Let us go to moon.
Alright, so thanks for checking out this week's Mining Payout. Stay tuned for next week's as well. And of course, shout out to this week's random comment winner. And if you did want to be featured, just write a comment below. Okay, so hope you enjoyed this video. Thumbs if you enjoyed it, sub if you study see what's next. But of course, thanks for watching, and always, happy mining.